Hello everyone, how is everyone doing? It is Mess Yourself here. Today we are back with another video. We are holding up the plushie today, which you can pick up at messyourself.com, guys, and we have some very important news. We have merch. Finally, we finally have merch, guys. You can get your Mess Yourself t-shirts. They are such great high quality, guys. We have two different types of t-shirts, one with the Mess Yourself face, but it is like all new and HD and redrawn. And we also have the other shirts with the Mess Yourself emojis all around it in black and red. Pretty awesome, guys. But also, if you can't afford that, then the plushie is the best way to go. Also, if you can't even afford that, but you also want some Mess Yourself merch, we now have Mess Yourself phone cases, guys. I have ordered mine. Mine is coming soon. So if you want to get that. Also, we have the Mess Yourself phone grip as well, if you want that. We have a lot of merch now, guys, right there. Go get it on messyourself.com, link in the description. Anyway, enough about my new cool t-shirts that are coming out now. Today we are reacting to some more animated horror stories. Today we are checking out IMR Scary Tales, guys. I love this guy's channel. He is a new horror story animation channel, guys. I think this guy is makes some really great videos, guys, honestly, and he's made so many. You guys need to go over to his channel right now and subscribe. Speaking of animations, guys, I wanted to wait for the merch to launch before we launched our new animation. We have our own animation channel, Mess Yourself Animations. We just uploaded a new animation. The more support we get on those animations, guys, the more animations we can make. Honestly, I do not make any money making these animations. I pay the animators a lot because they deserve to be paid a lot. So yeah, it doesn't make any money. All I want you guys to do is just watch it, enjoy it, grow the channel so I can afford to make more.
My name is Ashlyn, and this story happened 3 years ago.
Oh, Ashlyn.
I lived in an apartment in New York on the first floor. I work as an adult film actress and frequently get admirers.
Adult film
actress?
One day,
this guy who frequently tipped me on my OnlyFans messaged me. He asked the basic
questions.
Where are you from? Do you like what you do? How old are you?
$5?
Sometimes I only answer one question, or I won't answer at all if I get a weird vibe. After answering shortly, I continue with my day.
Imagine all the creeps on OnlyFans.
I had 100 notifications from all my social media from the same guy who messaged me earlier.
Ugh.
He was angry. He messaged me things like, I pay you so much money.
I pay you so much money.
You need to answer me now.
Answer me now. I pay you money.
So I blocked him on everything.
Block him.
If the story stopped there, this wouldn't be a horror story, money. Would it? 2 weeks later, my grandfather died, and I had to attend his funeral in Bosnia. Posted on my social media about my travels. Stupid, I know.
No.
But I was excited to be in my home country.
No.
When I returned home, I had this weird feeling, like I was being watched.
No.
I frequently watch horror animations, so I kind of became a paranoid but very safety-conscious person.
Me too, I do that too!
I went room to room checking with my gun in hand.
Take the
gun! I really felt something was off, so I opened my front door and closed it without actually leaving.
She has a gun?
Standing there quietly, I heard rustling in a room.
Rustling?
I point my gun as I slowly see a man coming from my film room closet. I yell,
stand still! Hands in the air, I'll shoot!
Shoot him! Shoot him!
A man with greasy long hair, dressed in all black, with bloodshot eyes, stood before me.
Shoot him!
I told him if he moved a muscle while I called the cops, I'd shoot.
Shoot.
He starts crying, pleading with me, saying, I just want to be with you. I'm in love with you. You need to be with me. My male neighbor heard everything and came in taking the greasy man down.
The neighbor came in?
The police arrived, and as they took the man into custody, they searched my house.
What?
They told me he was in my film room, hiding in a crawl space. They found his bag in there with food and drinks scattered around. There was ropes, knives, various chemicals, my underwear. He confessed that he'd been following me and had taken over 2,000 pictures of me for over a week. Allegedly, that wasn't the first time he was in my home. During the court case,
hell?
He kept staring at me.
Staring?
And smiling at me.
Oh.
As I was escorted out by a police officer, a woman approached me with a note, and the officer took it. It read, "This isn't the end."
Oh, creepy man!
She was taken in for questioning.
What?
It chills me to the bone knowing he was in my house without me knowing.
Wait, what?
He's currently in prison, and I have a restraining order. I also moved and updated my security. I now live with an armed bodyguard. Please be
an
safe.
An armed
if you're
bodyguard?
A woman, especially one in this industry.
She has so many people on OnlyFans, she can afford a personal bodyguard. What the sh-
This isn't the end.
This isn't the end. To what?
She was taken in for questioning.
She was taken in for questioning. Yeah, she should have done that more discreetly. But yeah, the end of what? So what? Is he going to come out of jail and kill him? Damn, guys, that makes me so scared. Honestly, do not use OnlyFans. Honestly, I was thinking about it, making an OnlyFans, but nah. All right, now I'm too scared to, honestly. I'd rather you guys just buy my merch, like my Mesh Yourself plushie, right on meshyourself.com. You know what I'm saying? Better use of money, you simp.
My older sister, Jen, is 5 years older than me.
Okay, here
we
go.
And the story also happened 5 years ago.
Scary
date.
Before
Jen was dating her current boyfriend, she was on Tinder to meet a few guys.
Tinder?
I remember the night specifically. She told me and our other sister, Maria, that she was meeting a guy at a bar a few blocks down.
Oh, no.
When she got there, she sat at the bar and texted the guy to let him know where she was sitting. Under a minute passed, and a man sat down next to her, offering to buy her a drink. This man was significantly older than my sister, and according to her, gave off a horrible smell. He had bad breath and crooked front teeth. She told him, no thank you, right away, as she had a guy coming to meet her.
That's
the man
the
didn't
guy.
Get up just yet. He kept sitting there. He said he would buy her a drink in the meantime before her date got there.
That's
Jen
the
felt
guy.
Very uncomfortable and asked the man to please leave her alone.
Oh.
The man got up from the bar stool and Jen told us that she did a side glance to see where the man had gone. She said he sat at one of the nearby table booths. Jen texted a date about what had just happened and asked him to please hurry.
So
there wasn't a response, so
him.
She sat there for a few minutes.
It's him,
she texted again, where are you?
Where
this
are
time
you?
The guy responded, running late, get a drink or two without me.
Oh.
Now, this was an odd text for a guy to send to a girl that he was meeting.
Yeah.
And to make it even worse, the man from before just came to sit back down next to Jen, asking
oh, no.
her where a date was, and acting all upset that she was still alone. My sister responded to the man once or twice, and then she'd had enough, and she asked him to please leave her alone.
Uh-oh.
Once again, she texted a date one more time, saying, sorry, I'm going to leave.
Oh.
As she sent it, the man's phone, which he had left on the bar, vibrated.
Uh-oh.
My sister immediately put two and two together, and she said she was going to go to the bathroom. She called her sister Maria, asking her what to do. Maria told her to just leave and drive home. I listened in on the conversation. When Jen left the bathroom, the man was no longer anywhere to be seen in the bar,
no,
which I'm sure she found
you.
To be a relief.
No.
She went straight to her car and started driving home.
He's
it's a very
you.
Linear and short path from that bar, and she was home in probably a couple of minutes.
Uh-oh.
When she pulled up in the driveway and started walking to the front door, she noticed another car pull up across the street. It didn't stop directly in front of the house. Across
told
the street,
you.
It stopped one house over. Jen came inside, and from here on, I can tell the story from my own point of view.
Oh.
Maria and I came to greet Jen and asked her what had happened. She went to the window and creased the blinds to look outside. She told us there was a car out there, and she was worried that the man had followed her. But when all three of us looked through
he
the
did,
blinds,
he did.
We didn't see a car out there. So she told us the unsettling story of what had happened at the bar. Maria did a better job at comforting her than I did. It's a girl thing, I guess. I did tell her that if that man ever set foot near her again, I'd kick his ass.
I'll kick
later
his
on,
ass.
We all went to our rooms and did our own thing. I was playing Far Cry 4 on my computer when I heard the horrible sound of both my sisters screaming. Let me shift back to Jen's perspective for a second. She was on her phone in bed when she got a text from that number. It said, hey, I'm sorry. I didn't see your text until I got to the bar.
That was
Jen
him.
Didn't answer. So he sent a follow-up text saying, I'm going to meet you at your house.
What?
Which window is yours?
What?
Jen called Maria to come to her room to look at the text. And as they talked for a little bit, figuring out what to do, Jen's window slid open and someone tried pushing their way through the roller shade. That was when both Maria and Jen screamed,
kick
causing not only me, but our parents from upstairs
parents?
To come rushing to her room.
What the
man trying to come in gave up before we even made it to the room. Our dad went outside to try and chase after the man, but he was already long gone, probably in his car.
His ass.
Of course, my dad called the cops to get the police report. Jen gave the police the man's cell phone number, and they took records of the text conversation. They said they were going to do what they could in order to trace the number,
what are they
although
do?
It could take a few days. My dad was contacted after the weekend by the local police station, and they asked him to come in to the station. They said they traced the number to be a fake number, through some app, and that there was no guarantee that they could trace the EUs back to the specific phone. My dad asked them to do whatever they could. Weeks passed, and we never heard from the police, but we all slowly started to forget about it. You can never really understand people's motives and how they think they can get away with something like climbing into a girl's window.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah, how could they think they can get away with that? What was he actually thinking was going to happen with the rest of his night? That he was going to climb through her window and like everything was just going to go smoothly. Creepy ass man, guys. Honestly, you need to be careful. I'm glad I watched these horror stories because it makes me so scared of meeting people online. You need to be careful not to meet some weirdo.
Weirdo.
I'm an Irish female. Oh. And this happened back in 2007.
I'm an Irish female.
When I was in my mid-20s.
Happened in 2007.
Back then, I loved going to clubs and dancing the night away.
I love going to clubs.
One particular night, I went out with some friends, which included my cousin Frank.
Oh.
We went to a nightclub, had some drinks, and danced to Daft Punk's
One
More Time.
What? Daft Punk's
as well
One
as
More
other
Time.
Popular
I
music
love that
at the
song.
Time.
One
I wasn't
more
living in
time.
This town at the time, so I arranged to stay at Frank's house.
Oh.
We had the fridge stocked with beer for when we got back and planned on getting wasted. We probably left the club at around 1 a.m.
1 a.m. to
and
get
got
wasted.
A taxi to his house.
Nice.
Back at Frank's house, we spent a few hours listening to Led Zeppelin. Nirvana Led Zeppelin. With a bit of Metallica thrown in for good measure.
Okay, we get it.
My cousin was in a rock band and loved the classics.
The classics.
At around 3 a.m., Frank's bandmate, Jack, called and asked if we can come over and stay.
3 a.m.?
He had been clubbing at a different location and needed somewhere to crash.
No!
Frank lived alone in a three-bedroom house.
Three-bedroom?
And being a single guy, he hosted a few wild parties over the years.
What the hell?
Frank told him no problem. He can come over, but explained we were having a quiet night. In other words, not to bring anyone else.
Yeah, you creep.
Jack came over and seemed super friendly.
Look at him.
Being
he's creepy.
The drummer
look at
of the
him.
Band, he looked
he's a
exactly
creepy guy.
Like what I expected. Long hair, a Zeppelin t-shirt, and ripped jeans. His behavior changed not long after arriving.
Uh-oh.
He was super animated.
Super animated.
And, I don't know, just on a different buzz.
Yeah, creepy.
He seemed drugged on something.
Oh, he's drugged.
And, hey, as long as he enjoys himself, who am I to judge?
It's 3 a.m. as
well. At
one
stage, he started playing air drums.
Air drums?
And continued with that for ages. During one of the air drum solos,
air drums.
I asked him something, and he didn't answer.
I'm playing
I
air
kinda
drums.
I kind of nudged him, very lightly, but just to get his attention. Jack went crazy and started shouting at me to never interrupt him when he was playing drums.
Whoa, but he wasn't
drums?
Playing drums.
Sorry. Did he really think he was playing real ones?
Is he playing real drums or air drums?
This pissed me off. I didn't like the aggression.
Aww.
Frank said, relax, man.
Yeah, relax,
There's
man.
There's no need to shout.
Yeah, why shouting, you weird guy?
No one should interrupt me when I'm in the zone, man. No one.
No one.
Me and Frank
Jeez.
I rolled and carried on chatting,
That's,
drinking and ignoring
creepy.
Him. The atmosphere changed after that.
Yeah, you got ruined.
And after a short time, I went to bed. I don't know how long after, but I was awoken from a deep sleep.
Uh-oh.
I heard this breathing sound in my room. Still in a drunken slumber, it took me a few minutes to register that the noise sounded like someone inhaling.
Oh, no.
Someone was in my bed.
Oh,
with a bunch
no.
of my hair in his hand, sniffing me. I froze, then said, what the f*** are you doing?
What are you doing?
Jack replied, relax.
Relax.
I'm just smelling your hair.
Relax. I'm just smelling
I'm
your hair.
I'm not gonna do anything.
I'm not gonna
well,
do that.
Well, adrenaline coursed through me, but I was stuck to the bed with fear, and the room was pitch black. I shouted, Frank! At the top of my voice. And in speedy time, he ran in the room.
Whoa.
Turned on the light, only to find Jack in my bed.
Whoa.
Holding a handful of my hair. He said, it's not what it looks like, bud. I was only smelling it. I was sleeping facing the door.
It's not what it looks like,
so
bud.
So could see Frank.
Right. I was just smelling
it.
I
did not to look behind me to
Come
see
on,
Jack.
Bud.
But his voice sounded like that of a child that
Aww.
Knows he's done something wrong.
Ew.
And is about to get in trouble.
Yeah, get in trouble.
Frank lost it. Told him to get the fuck downstairs.
Yeah, get out.
My cousin apologized and said he did not want to kick him out of the house in the drugged up state he was in.
I think you should.
The door had no lock. So my cousin slept in a chair in front of my bedroom door. Jack actually tried to come in again. I woke to Frank telling him to get the hell back downstairs. He was going to kick him out of the house.
Yeah, he tried
Jack
to come in a second
once
time.
Again. The next day he was gone by the time I woke up.
What a weird guy. Is he gone now?
A few days later, when Frank tracked Jack down,
he
was told he'd been mixing drugs with alcohol and was embarrassed by his behavior. Even though it's been years since it happened, it still gives me the creeps when I think about it.
That is creepy.
Those sniffing sounds. Big, deep, slow inhales still give me goosebumps. The band broke up not long after that. So,
the band
I never
broke
had to meet him
after.
Again. I was told he was a good guy.
Was he, though?
I'm just glad Frank was there. Or who knows how I would have gotten him out of my room.
Damn. Jeez. All these animations have been about women, guys. Honestly. We should feel bad for women. Why is the world so scary as a woman, honestly? Okay, one more.
We lived in a very mundane apartment complex that only had 3 floors, but that didn't bother me.
That didn't bother me.
I stayed home most of the time.
Yeah.
One afternoon, I was home alone with my maid, who was cooking lunch for me. After lunch, she told me that she had to go work at someone's house that evening, and that she didn't know when she'd be back.
Oh.
I remember feeling extremely sad, and that must have been evident on my face because she responded to my looks by saying, "You can come with me if you like. It's just a few doors down, not much of a walk."
Don't do it. Don't
My eyes lit up when she said this.
Uh-oh.
The following evening, we arrived at the house.
I could hear the television
from where I was.
My
maid knocked on the door, but no one answered.
It's creepy
when
house.
She knocked again, a young woman opened the door.
No.
She was sort of a partner for my maid who would work with her majority of the time.
Oh.
We stepped inside, and immediately my eyes alighted to a very porky-looking woman with disheveled hair lying down on the couch holding a television remote.
Porky?
To my left, 2 young boys sat in front of each other, busying themselves with toy blocks. My maid asked me to play with them, so I obliged. I sat down beside them as my maid and her friend strode out of the living room and into the kitchen. This is where the story starts to take a turn.
Oh.
10 minutes after I sat down, I heard the woman suddenly gasp for air whilst clutching her chest.
Uh-oh.
My heart sank and the blocks dropped from my hand.
What happening to
my
her?
My maid and her friend
What's
rushed in
to
and
her?
Saw the woman's face turning blue.
Look at her!
She kept croaking the words, "Big man! Big man!
Big man!"
Just then, a dark shadow materialized beside her.
What
he was so tall that he stretched up to the ceiling.
Pigman!
I was so scared I couldn't even think straight. The 2 boys next to me looked just as shocked as I was. Then, the woman fell silent and her eyes clamped shut. It was silent for almost a full minute before her eyes shot open again.
Whoa.
And I swear, I thought her pupils had turned just a shade darker.
Whoa.
I wish I wasn't there for what happened next. The woman began laughing like a maniac. Her wide eyes darted in their sockets from one end of the room to the next. She kept puffing up her chest and writhing around like a terrified worm. My maid stumbled
back, hit
the edge of the couch, and fell to the floor, throwing her hands behind to catch her balance.
Whoa.
Meanwhile, her friend sprinted towards the balcony behind us, slid the sliding glass door open, and proceeded to throw herself out of it in fear.
This triggered
my instincts, so I jumped up, and so did the 2 boys beside me.
We tried our
best to stop her from falling over.
Whoa.
My maid rushed in, and together, we hurled her backwards. My maid then grabbed her friend by the shirt, pulled her close, and said, "If we are going to get through this, we are going to together." We re-entered the living room, and by this point,
the woman was on
her knees with her arms above her head. She began waving them madly.
Oh.
My maid opened the door and left, leaving her petrified friend behind with us.
Oh my god, run away!
The woman began taunting her, her eyes open wider than ever. Moments later, my maid arrived with 2 people, an older man and a younger woman. The woman took one look at the man, and her whole face fell as she threw him the blankest stare. Then, she began to growl as he approached her and shook her head violently as if to say no. The man took the remote and turned on the TV.
Oh.
He played around with the channels
until
he found one where a priest was reading a Bible verse. The woman fell to the floor and thrashed around wildly. The man bravely walked up to her and placed a hand over her forehead, then began threatening the spirit so that it would leave. After what felt like forever, the woman fell silent again. The man then turned to my maid and her friend, who were now shaking uncontrollably, and said, "I have to spend the night here. I can't leave this woman alone with her kids.
What?
You have to leave now."
This ain't a hotel.
The 2 women didn't say anything, but merely shook their heads.
What?
My maid then did something which I felt to be extremely stupid.
Stupid?
She volunteered to spend the night with him, and her friend reluctantly agreed,
looking
at her as if she had gone mad. This meant that I had to spend the night too, since I didn't like sleeping alone. The night whizzed by uneventfully.
That's scary.
And the next morning when I awoke, the house felt quiet. Just then, my maid walked into the living room with that same friend of hers and stood a few inches away from the couch.
Uh-oh.
They began silently arguing with each other over something I couldn't quite comprehend. But when the argument was over, my maid was the first one to step up. She tapped the woman on the shoulder and the woman opened her eyes.
You want some tea?
Something about her eyes told me that she had returned to her normal self, but I wasn't all convinced of this theory.
Is she?
The woman sat up and looked at my maid in the eye. My maid then proceeded to ask her, Ma'am, would you like some coffee?
Would you like
some
coffee?
The woman took a few seconds to respond. But when she did, it wasn't her voice that we all heard, but a deep, gruff voice like that of a man.
What?
It echoed off the walls of the house as she said,
No.
No!
A few years later, my maid recalled that incident to me. She then told me something that chilled me to the bone. She told me that a few months before that happened, her husband had assaulted and killed their 13-year-old daughter.
What?
Right before drowning himself in the bathtub.
What?
To this day, I will never understand why she didn't just move out of that house.
What?
I'm 15 years old now, and that experience still haunts me to this day.
Wait, what? Wait, what was that bit at the end? So her husband killed his daughter and drowned himself? How do you drown yourself? How do you drown yourself in your bathtub too? How? Like, how do you actually do that?
Anyway, I probably shouldn't know.
Anyway, guys, these animations were pretty awesome, I think. And this is why you should definitely go over to IMR Scary Tales YouTube channel and subscribe. He's posting so many horror story animations now. And honestly, I am loving it. Loving his consistency. He works hard, guys. So go show him that support. Thank you guys so much for watching. Go check out meshyourself.com if you want to pick up some merch or the plushie. Also, Mesh Yourself Animations. The new animation is up now. Go watch it. It is live right now, today. Go watch it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.